Ladies and gentlemen, jury, on April 26, 2013, Christopher Jimmery was a young man with a future, a life full of possibilities. He had a decent job, he had a woman that loved him, and his child, his little girl, was the center of his universe. All of that ended when Christian Cruz and Justin Charles stormed through his back door. Christian Cruz has been indicted for the crimes of first-degree murder, burglary while armed, robbery with a firearm, and kidnapping for his participation in the event of April 26th that led to the killing of this innocent young man. The facts of this case will show that Christopher Jimmery was sitting on his couch, eating a late dinner and watching TV when two strangers broke into his apartment. Presumably, they were there in search of drugs. The only problem is Christopher Jimmery isn't a drug dealer. Christopher Jimmery isn't a drug user. He merely lived in an apartment where the former tenant used and smoked and sold small quantities of marijuana. Christian Cruz and Justin Charles made a terrible mistake. But rather than realizing what they had done and backing out, the two men continued to use force and violence, pushing this terrifying scenario to its extreme and unnecessary. Christopher Jimmery was tied with speaker wire and bound with duct tape, his mouth covered and his hands wrapped. He was thrown the trunk of his own car, a helpless victim controlled by his captors.
The reasonable doubt in the case is an all-criminal case in Florida that arises from the evidence and the lack of evidence or from conflicts in the evidence. And it is during the course of the trial that I suspect as to a lot of the matters that were just discussed by Mr. Will, you will find conflicts in that evidence. You will have questions about missing evidence or the lack of evidence. And you will have conflicts